Welcome to SF Cryptocurrency Dev Interviews. It's a pleasure tonight to have David Gobad here with me from Mobius. And we're going to ask David a little bit of questions about him and his company and what they're doing on the blockchain and Stellar. David, welcome.
Thanks for having me.
Awesome. All right. Thank you for coming. David, thank you for a great presentation for SF Cryptocurrency Devs, where you introduced us to the Mobius Network. And thank you for the awesome winners of the competition that you announced and also the demos that we got to see. Why don't we start by you telling me, who are you, man, and where did you come from?
Right. So I'll tell you, I guess, a little bit about myself. I studied computer science at Stanford, then I went to law school at Harvard, continued to have this interest in technology, and sort of rediscovered blockchain, I guess, a little over a year ago from talking to an old friend. And, you know, really saw that there were amazing advances in the technology. Ethereum and Stellar, et cetera. I saw what was going on and started, you know, doing some programming on Ethereum, trying to make a simple token and integrate it.
Yeah. What made you think I have to start doing that stuff? Like when you started writing code, like what was the flicker in your mind that said, oh, I'm going to start writing code on this blockchain stuff?
Yeah, well, I mean, the technology was just super interesting. You know, I mean, I had looked at Bitcoin, I don't know, 5+ years ago, and you know, thought it was cool, and saw, you know, digital gold, and then, you know, I come back and I was doing, you know, a bunch of other startups and stuff, and then this friend told me about it, and I looked at CoinMarketCap, and I'm like, whoa.
That's right.
I'm like, there were just so many of them.
Yeah.
I'm like, wow, the space has really grown. I really looked into what Ethereum was, and you know, saw it was a it was truly this global, open, sort of secure in some sense, global supercomputer that anyone could use.
Yep.
And I mean, it just really like caught my interest. I'm like, this is pretty awesome.
And then what inspired you to start Mobius? How did that happen?
Well, it was really just from, so I started, you know, writing, I made a simple token, tried to integrate it with this little game, literally Flappy Bird, and it was hard.
Yeah.
It was like, you know, I had to learn all this new stuff. I had to run an Ethereum node, monitor the network for these incoming transactions. Just, you know, putting together the Ethereum transactions in like the Ruby code to like send the tokens. You know, there wasn't really a good SDK. I had to try and find out how to like piece together the, you know, byte strings.
Yep.
And, you know, really bad documentation, just couldn't find anything. And then I was talking to other people that wanted to do the same thing, and they were all reinventing the wheel. So that sort of came up with the first product idea, which was Stripe for blockchain. And then that grew into the dApp store. I was sort of like, well, let's make it easy for developers. And then I realized, well, it's just as hard for users.
Yep.
You know, how can we make it easy for both users and consumers, or users and developers to truly use cryptocurrency for something other than speculation, to really make crypto commerce happen?
Now, you were successful in raising via an ICO, correct?
Well, we did a token sale.
Token sale.
I mean, we did a token sale. We had a good amount of revenue.
Right.
Now,
you're one of the few token sales that I've seen that actually has a product that is having an impact on people's lives. Mm-hmm. Can you talk a little bit about the impact that Mobius.network is having on the folks who are publishing the dApp store?
Yeah, so, you know, we launched our dApp store way back in August, maybe even July, before, you know, we sold any tokens because, well, we wanted to make sure that we, you know, had a real product to sell.
Yeah.
And, you know, immediately, we also got a bunch of developers to sign up and start making apps. And one of them is based in Nigeria and is actually, I think he said August 2017, so like that month, I think he ended up making, he said, more than $10,000, which is more than two times.
Hold on a second. So you guys created this dApp store on Stellar.
Yeah.
And Stellar's what, top 5, 10 cryptocurrency?
Yeah, so I think the top 10.
And through your app and your platform, people are now making thousands of dollars in places like Nigeria.
Yeah, he made a number of games. You know, he's been in the Stellar community for a while.
Right.
He really liked what we were doing at the dApp store.
Right.
He started making some games, and yeah, people played them, and he made over $10,000, which is more than double the annual salary or the annual income in Nigeria.
It's an amazing story, and so you're now getting more developers like this to come on and build and to deploy and publish dApps on Mobius?
Yeah, I mean, we just today relaunched the dApp store. So we made it more decentralized, non-custodial, and a 100% new, completely new UI.
Yeah.
Designed by a former Netflix, I think, senior designer.
Cool. I also heard that you guys have Jackson Palmer as an advisor.
Well, he was an advisor. He actually stopped advising all companies.
Okay.
We're still friends.
Okay.
But he actually did stop officially, but he stopped advising all companies.
Got it.
A while.
But while he was an advisor, what did he like also about what you were doing?
Yeah. I think the technology.
Yeah.
I think we're the first blockchain project to announce we were going to be on Stellar, and we are the biggest one to date.
Got it.
So, I think we really were the first ones to see the benefits of Stellar, which, can be summarized as today it's 1,000 transactions a second on average, which
Amazing.
Is over 100 times faster than Ethereum.
Yep.
In terms of cost, on average, it's around 100,000 times cheaper per transaction. And we say it's more secure, and that it, one simple yet really important feature is it natively supports multi-sig text.
How easy it is for publishers and developers to write on Mobius today?
So it's extremely easy. We're continuing to improve documentation. We're going to make a new developer portal. We have SDKs now, I think, live in Ruby, PHP, and Node. We've got Python in development. So just continuing to build out the developer ecosystem.
And I hear you're giving away money to make that happen.
We're giving away Mobi, yeah.
How much?
So we have our global hackathon is running now. The submission deadline is August 18th. There is info on our blog, and the prize, there are four different categories, and it is 200,000 Mobi per category.
Wow. That's awesome. So you guys are really committing to the community build out.
Yeah, definitely.
All right. What's Mobi going to look like in 5 years?
Wow, in 5 years. Well, what we say the vision is make crypto commerce a reality. So you go to Starbucks, you pay with cryptocurrency, and it's basically Mobius technology, on your phone and on, Starbucks' point of sale system that's making this all happen.
Got it. All right. Well, thank you so much, David. It's a pleasure. Congratulations on Mobi's success, and we'll see you again in 5 years.
Yeah. Thank you so much. I appreciate it.
Thank you. See you guys.
Yeah.